The Christmas season is filled with so many beautiful hymns. Silent Night, Away in the Manger, Joy to the World. One of the hymns entitled, Of the Father's Love Begotten, is one of the oldest Christmas hymns we have. It was written as a poem in the 5th century by Christian poet Marcus Prudentius. He tried to capture the mystery of this beautiful day. Of the Father's love begotten, ere the world began to be, He is Alpha and Omega, He the source, the ending, He. Of the things that are, that have been, and the future years shall see, evermore and evermore. Sacred Scripture says, For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him might not perish, but might have eternal life. When the world sat in darkness and despair, God entered our world in a most unusual way. In an act of unconditional love, God humbled himself and was born of the Virgin, one like us in all things but sin. He who created the heavens and the earth gives himself to us today in the Eucharist, his very body and blood, the bread of life for us to eat. In imitation of Jesus, we are to give of our very selves to one another, to think first of others' needs. Oh, that birth forever blessed, when the Virgin full of grace, by the Spirit blessed conceiving, bore the Savior of our race. And the babe, the world's redeemer, first revealed his sacred face, evermore and evermore. Jesus reveals his sacred face to us each and every day. One of the most important spiritual tools in life is the gift of awareness. In the midst of the ordinary, everyday experiences of life, the face of Jesus is revealed to us over and over again. We are told in the Gospels that Mary pondered so many things in her heart. Mary collected the encounters in life that led her into the mystery of God's love for her. There was so much she could not understand, and yet, as a woman of faith, she trusted. Even as Mary held the mystery of the manger and the mystery of the cross standing at its foot, she remained faithful to God. Mary teaches us to heighten our awareness of God. God who is present with us in times of peace, as well as in time of danger and challenge. I think we would all agree this past year has been one big challenge. I saw a Christmas ornament that said, the year 2020, stink, stank, stunk. It's from The Grinch Who Stole Christmas, if some of you know that movie. The challenges of this past year, the COVID-19 pandemic, Racial tensions in our country, political divides everywhere. We must never forget, in spite of all this stuff, the promise that Jesus made to us. Jesus says, "I am with you always until the end of the ages." What is the focus of your life? Darkness or light? Were you able to ponder the beauty of the Bethlehem star we witnessed this week? I was up in Wapakoneta visiting Mom, and we went out just as the sun was going down, and we could see that bright light in the sky. And I just thought about, God, how amazing you are to create all of this, and everything having its cycle and movement going on. God holds it all in his hands. Ponder the innocence of a child running up to you to give you a hug. And recognize that as God giving you a hug. For the face of Christ is revealed to us in many ways. Think of the warmth of your home this morning, the food on your table. That is God protecting you and nourishing you. Consider the greetings of family and friends. Some of that will happen over Zoom today. God is both perfectly hidden and perfectly revealed in all of creation. Each day, I invite you to pause at various times in the day, nothing structured, but be mindful of God through the course of your day. Make a prayer of whatever catches your attention or has you thinking a little bit more than usual. Maybe it's something joyful, maybe it's something sorrowful, but all things we can place in God's hands in a prayer. That's what it means to live always in the Lord, to be mindful of God. Let the heavens and heights adore him. Angels host his praises sing. Powers, dominions bow before him and extol our God and King. Let no tongue on earth be silent, every voice in concert ring, evermore and evermore. This is why we are here today, to bring all of our voices together and to proclaim our belief that the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. God is with us. Our normal schedule for a Friday is thrown out the window as we pause to thank and to praise God for the mystery of his love for us. Indeed, the Word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we saw his glory, the glory of a Father's only Son, full of grace, full of truth. The light of Christ scatters the darkness we experience in life. The light of Christ brings justice, peace, hope, love. This is what must be first and foremost in our minds. My brothers and sisters, God did not leave us to our own demise. God came to save us and to lead us to life. So you and I have a choice to make. Will you believe the truth of God's love for you, for me, for all people? Or will you follow the plan of the evil one and sit in darkness, doubt and fear? This is Christ whom seers and sages heralded with one accord, whom the voices of the prophets promised in their faithful word. Christ has come, the long expected. Let creation praise its Lord evermore and evermore.